So many of you have to fail a lot of times for these ideas that you have to become something worth, worth an organization, worth a business. The point is that many of us are not ready for the startup life. For many of us sitting here, we feel that entrepreneurship is a walk in the park, and it's one that when you start, the money starts doing like that, and it starts going. It's never too. For an average business, it takes 18 months for you to even break even, and to even take a profit. But the challenges are so big that they are not becoming much. And so when you are solving the problem, the first thing to do is to look at your customer segments. Which is that, what problem exists today? What problem exists today? How do I solve it? Where are the people who have these problems? That's how you start discovering a business idea. Look around your environment and discover what is it that people are doing that they need a better solution for. Or people are going to a point where every people are facing problems in your home, your family, your own problems. These are ways to discover your business idea. Am I making sense so far? Am I making sense so far? That's the way to discover a business idea. Problems. Problems. When you find a problem, find out where these people are, who have the problem, and how best your solutions can get to them. So in the definition of a business model compass, yes, have the idea. But does it solve the need? Does it solve a problem? Now from there, you look at it from, okay, this idea that I have, what value does it give these people? The idea that you guys have right now, the best way to put it in a structure is to do it in the business model form. So what value are you offering these people? Includes what products you have for people to buy. You don't have a product no one would buy from you. I hear people telling me, and I have an idea, I want to help women, and I want to do this, I want to do that. But women is a huge demographic said that it will be so. But within the women's bracket, there are teenage pregnant women, true or false. That would be the problem. Teenage pregnant women and not women as a whole. When I hear people say, oh, I want to do that, I address it in the main presentation. This is just an opener for you. So what value do I have that I'm giving to my customers? Address that. Simple way to structure your business idea. Now, the channel means that how do I reach the people who have these problems with my solution that I define in the value proposition? Therefore, then you need to look at what key resources you need to deliver this to them. Now, while doing so, you need to look at what relationships you need to build within your business idea to reach these people who have the problem. Now, after that, you need to look at what key activities you need to put in your business, in your idea, to meet these needs. Marketing, HR, technology, all these things are key activities that you need to do or put into your business if you want to reach your clients. Now, again, in structuring your business idea, look at it from who are my key partners? Which people do I need to leverage on to deliver the solution to the market I want to sell? Are you with me so far? Okay. Now from there, you look at it from the point that everything you said here comes with a cost. This is very practical. Everything you said here comes with a cost. So what is the cost thereof in delivering your solution? Then you look at how you will price to make money. That is the business model. So what we tell people is that beyond creating a business plan for your idea, you need to get the business model right. And I think 20 people of you have done that so well, true or false. Fundamentally, what is most important in a business is get the business model right. Who are my customers? First one. What are their problems? Second point. What solution do I have? Third point. Is my solution unique? What am I offering them? That's it. Value proposition. How do I reach them? The channel. What relationship do I need to build with them to reach them? That's right. Now, what key activities do I need to put? So you are building structure within your idea. What we realize is that most ideas by students are not structured. They're not realistic in nature. Then look at it from who are my partners? Which people do I need to leverage on to deliver this product? Look at it from the cost part of it. Price it well. When the cost is lesser than the revenue, you make money. Let's move on to the main presentation. Then we'll take it from there. So, like I'm saying, all of you have ideas, but get a business model. My first point to you. So, today we are here in TNUSD, and all of you say you have ideas. Like I've told you, the idea may not be the business. All of you have ideas, it's just one of it that will become an ultimate business. Slide, next one. So, practice to consider in transforming the idea that you all have. Number one, you should be able to explain what you do in one sentence. In one sentence, you should tell someone what you do, how you do it, and when to do it in one sentence. Most of you, like I said, when we ask what do you do, it's going to be a whole story altogether. I can give you a practical example right now. When you're telling someone about your business idea, be clear enough about its model to tell the person how you're going to grow and how the business idea will change over time. Most of you that will be considered within 3 years of change in the context of the business model. Number three, the idea that you have must grab people's attention. Because there are problems in this world, but not all the problems can bring you money. That's why there are two motives in establishing a business. One is that you do it for profit, or you do it for impact. But even within the impact model, you need to make something from profit to be sustainable. Are you with me so far? Oh, I can't show the vibe. Are you with me so far?
Yes.
Good. Let's do a practical example. How many of you have ideas? Show my hand. I saw the hand. Show. Say, come. I want a lady. I saw a lady. Did you raise your hand? Okay, please come. One more from the back. How many of you have ideas? Show my hand. The world wants to hear ideas. Say, please come. Your idea must grab people's attention because it must resonate with the feeling of problems you have. That's the only way they'll buy your product. That's the only way they'll personalize your business or service. That's the only way you will grow as a businessman. Please tell us your business idea.
My idea is PASO. Now, PASO is a service which desires to give students a personalized learning experience, in that you are able to have access to past questions and answers right from your smartphone or your PC.
Event management
and I'm specifying
the catering aspect
as the aspect. Thank you. Mine has to do with deworming. Deworming. And I'm forming the deworm team that will launch out to deworm and educate students about the need for them to deworm and then sell products to them. Thank you.
Please be up here for all of them. Which one are you likely to put money in? Let's start. So I just want to get I, okay? Okay, this one?
I.
This one?
I.
Hey, this one?
I.
Oh, let's do that again. Okay, so it's between this and that. Well, we'll start over. This one? Pasco?
I.
Pasco?
I.
Event management?
I.
You well. Okay. Let me find out from some of you why you go for PASO. Why you go for the best. Anybody for PASO? Show my hand. Why would you go for PASO?
So I'll go for the PASO because now the education sector is very broad and a lot of people are eager to are writing exams and are eager to pass.